A lot of talk has been going on between the WhatsApp conversations that took place between Greta Thunberg and Disha. Two principal questions the supporters of this arrest are asking: if there was nothing wrong they had done, why A, they deleted the group, and number two, why was it that Disha was already talking to about Rue PA and her lawyers? If she's so informed about environmental issues, could Disha be ignorant of what possibly she had done? This is what the BJP and the supporters of this arrest are asking. Take a look at what is there in these WhatsApp chats.
India Today has accessed WhatsApp chats between activist Greta Thunberg and Disha Ravi, and this is moments after Greta tweeted out the farmer protest toolkit. These chats are from 9:23 p.m. to 9:41 p.m. on the 3rd of February.
Sends two new links on the accidental leak of document. It would be really good to have it ready now. I will receive so many threats because of this. It's really blowing up.
Sending it to you. Okay, can you not tweet the toolkit at all? Can we just not say anything at all for a while? I'm going to talk to lawyers. I'm sorry, but our names are on it and we can literally get UAPA against us. Are you okay?
I need to write something.
Can you give me 5 minutes? I'm talking to the lawyers.
These hate storms happen sometimes and they are really intense.
Sure. I'm really, really sorry. We're all panicking because this is getting really bad here. But we will make sure you are in the clear. We just have to deactivate all socials.
What's clear from this WhatsApp excerpt is that the activists did not want the toolkit to go public and knew it would spell trouble for them. With Arvind Ojha in Delhi, Bureau Report, India Today.
There are certain very important questions that I want to raise this evening, and I will go across with those questions to Adil Singh Boparai of the Congress Party. We'll also be joined by Anila Singh of the Bharatiya Janata Party. I welcome both of you. But before, in fact, I go to my guest, I just want to a couple of questions just to set the premise of this debate. What we were, and you must have read a lot of reports and a lot of opinion, has the government and the cops overreacted as far as this entire toolkit case is concerned? Because the challenge would be not only to present in front of the court that this toolkit was in fact one instrument that resulted in the violence on 26 January and then there was a deeper conspiracy as well. What we also want to raise this evening is what laws did the toolkit break? What were the specific laws? Sedition on somebody editing or tweeting out something? Is there a larger conspiracy at play and is gathering support for farmers an offense in New India? I want to start with you, Anila Singh. I just want to understand, because now you have seen at a time when questions are being raised about muzzling the voice of the protesters, of people, those who have views differing from the government. Is editing a toolkit or even saying that we are not happy with the Indian state or, you know, criticizing the government now amounting to sedition, ma'am?
Ankit, if somebody says that muzzling the voice of those who conspire against our great country is some type of atrocity or attack on democracy, I feel sad for them. Nothing can be above our country. Nothing, absolutely nothing. So people living in our country and people who are living abroad who conspire to create ruckus in our country, to weaken the government, to instigate the feelings, and to tell the people what they have to do and what they don't have to do via toolkit, and then when everything comes out, then they start playing the victim card. And the sad part is political parties like Congress, Aam Aadmi Party and others, they say, अरे ये क्या 21 साल की बच्ची को आप अरेस्ट कर रहे हो? Did she do the work of बच्ची? Conspiring against your own country is the work of a बच्ची? Absolutely not. Ankit, I'm pretty sure that you must have gone through the toolkit.
Ma'am, you are... I have gone through the toolkit, and that is why, before I go to Adil, I want to ask you, I could not find anywhere where she is saying pick up arms to destroy this country. I could not find anywhere where she is saying let there be a bloodbath. I could not find anywhere where she is saying we will indulge in any kind of violence. How is it that creating a Twitter storm in support of farmer issues, even if it is against the government, that becomes so seditious, ma'am? Sedition, criticizing the government or participating in a farmer's protest, criticizing the government is not equal to conspiring against India, ma'am. Government is not India.
Government is not India, but India is India, and of course, the people who are protesting. So definitely, we know it very well that how they were protesting against the government. But the thing is, you are saying what is wrong in creating Twitter storm? There is absolutely nothing wrong in it. But when that leads to ruckus, when it leads to people attacking on police force, when it leads to many other sad things, then definitely we have to think that, yes, it was pre-planned. And we know it very well that how it started.
Okay. And the people but that who is are a part of the investigation. Even the Delhi police right now is not saying that toolkit is directly resultant. Whatever happened on 26 January is because of that toolkit. That's not even the Delhi police what it is saying. They are saying we are investigating any link, and that would be very crucial. But Adil Singh Boparai, if the Delhi police is going through an investigation, the investigation is not complete. Is the opposition jumping too soon by saying, look, somebody is being victimized? The police is saying we are doing a job. If she has not done nothing, then she will possibly be out, from the courts.
Well, Ankit, a citizen of this country has a right to say anything against the government or its measures, as long as it does not incite violence or does not seek to overthrow the government through violent disorder. Now, there are two critical preconditions before sedition can be invoked. Number one, as a result of your acts, you incite violence. And number two, through your actions, you are seeking to overthrow the government through a violent disorder. Now, the genius Bharatiya Janata Party spokesperson, I would urge her to show me a line from the toolkit which seeks to incite violence. Point number one. Point number two, what is a toolkit? Toolkit is an explainer's guide. In the age of social media, in the 21st century, organizations, including the BJP IT cell, run social media storms, Twitter storms, when there are coordinated tweets by ministers of the government of India, by their so-called lackeys in the Bollywood. There is a coordinated attempt to sustain a movement. Now, as a citizen of this country, let's assume for the sake of argument without conceding, even if she is an editor of the so-called toolkit, which does not incite violence, which seeks to support or sustain or give a flip to the farmer movement, how is this an offense under law? When you seek to bring a charge under law, you have to satisfy the preconditions under the Indian Penal Code. How is supporting a movement an offense under law? How is being a part of a WhatsApp group an offense under law? Tomorrow, Ankit Tyagi and Adil Boparai can be part of a WhatsApp group where we exchange messages and say that the government's policies are wrong, that farmers are losing their lives because of the government's insensitivity. Are we going to be charged for sedition? The BJP just does not have any understanding how democracy
and Anila runs. Singh, number three. I have been morning. I just want to take that to Anila Singh, Adil, and then I'm just going to come back to you. Anila Singh, I also want to understand this because, a lot of the spokesperson from your party have been coming and saying, oh, why did she delete that WhatsApp group if there was nothing wrong? Ma'am, I am a member of 20 WhatsApp groups. I delete every third WhatsApp group on my phone. Tomorrow, if something happens, that doesn't make me guilty or libelous just because I deleted. It's my choice. It's my WhatsApp group. The other question I want to ask you, Mo Dhaliwal and certain other names have been taken. Please tell me, were these people on any watch list of the government? Did the government tell the citizens of India that these people are not to be interacted with, or they should be, or they would be libelous, or they would be held accountable because they are anti-India people? There has been no FIR from the government of India. His group has not been banned by the government of India. So why is somebody just for interacting with, XYZ person now being called anti-India forces?
What you're doing right now, it is called media trial. Ankit, first of all, what you are saying that this particular organization, Poetic Justice Foundation, it was not banned. And the government did not tell the people of our country that this particular organization is banned and you should not have any type of relation or any type of communication with this organization. If you're going to have it, then it will, you will be criminalized. But let me tell you, just now you said that many of Bharatiya Janata Party spokespersons, they said that why did she delete that particular chat from the WhatsApp group? I'm not going to comment on that because that is the work of the investigative agencies. They are going to find it. But yes, right from the beginning, this has been said that there are we can trace the roots of the protests and links of the protests out of the country as well. So the eyes of the investigative agencies were there in Canada, in US, Italy, wherever, from wherever the support was coming. So you cannot say that the government was not vigilant. And secondly, just now, innocent friend of mine from Congress party, Mr. Adil, he explained what toolkit is. Mr. Adil, I'll tell you what protest toolkit is. Protest toolkit usually provides methods for holding protests, tool and hashtags to create momentum on social media. And the guidelines too. And this is what this particular toolkit was telling. When this toolkit tells that what type of social media storm you have to bring and what type of hashtags you have to create. So this very well tells that how they wanted to inflame the feelings of the people. They wanted that there should be violence on the roads of the Delhi. And this is what the government is
saying. Hashtags every other day. Will people be put behind bars because they suggested certain hashtags?
No, no, it is
anyway,
not about certain hashtags.
I want to go across to Adil Singh Boparai. Adil,
but we get hashtags and we trend.
Okay.
But if you are going to trend something which goes against our country, then definitely we have to arrest them and we have to ask them questions.
BJP is not India.
Who decides that? I don't understand this bizarre comparison. It's overreach. But Adil, in conclusion, I want to understand from you, why is it? Ma'am, I will decide for myself. If you... Not the government. Not even the government. Anila Singh, please. Understand one thing, not the government, not the investigating agency, none of them can decide. It is the courts that will decide whether she is guilty or not. So ma'am, please don't tell me that the government, you or anybody else will decide whether what I'm saying is an overreach or not. Adil Singh Boparai, I want to understand from you in conclusion, what would you say to the critics, those who have been saying that if this girl was innocent, she is a professional, environmental activist, did she not know that she is interacting with a supposed Khalistani link?
Ankit, let me go back to the root issue. Even editing a toolkit in support of the farmer movement, unless and until that toolkit through its language, written or verbal, seeks to incite violence, is not an offense. The contours of Section 124A of the Indian Penal Code says that unless and until an act seeks to incite violence, it is not sedition. This is the law of the land. Anila ji should read the Supreme Court judgments in Kulwant Singh's case and Kedarnath's case. Point number one. Point number two, a 21-year-old girl is scared by the environment today in this country.
Okay.
The environment of intolerance, the environment of hate, the environment of trolling. So if she withdraws from a WhatsApp group because she is scared, given the conduct of this government over the past 7 years, there is nothing unusual. Number three, basic canons under the CRPC being violated. When this girl was produced before the magistrate, the least he deserves, Ankit, was legal representation to oppose the remand.
Okay.
Number four, can a country of 1.3 billion, can the Indian state with all its apparatus be scared of one girl or one environmentalist? Mr. Modi, by his policies, by his conduct, by his authoritarian measures...
Adil, I'm completely out of time. I'm completely out of time. I will have to leave it there, sir. Sorry, I'm completely out of time. I have to leave it there. But the moot point of this debate once again is, can the government, in fact, without anybody calling for arms, decide that this is sedition? Has the police been at least been overzealous by putting all these charges as far as this girl is concerned? Investigation will tell. The courts will have to decide. Thank you so much to both of you for joining us on 6 p.m. Prime. News and updates continue after a short break.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.